Cyrus Fees, MMA Inside the Cage, Fight Now TV. We're here at the Arnold Sports Festival 2013, right outside the Expo. And look who I ran into, Mr. International, Shoni Carter, in the house, man.
Yes.
How are you doing, man? I know you're out here at the Arnold. You got some work you're doing. Talk about that.
I'm doing a seminar at the Red Roof Inn. I want to give to the guys something other than a double leg. I want to give them the judo and the Greco-Roman for MMA. And it's 7 p.m. tonight, and I want you guys to like learn the explosive, that crowd pleasing, that definitive moment inside a fight or even a jiu-jitsu match. I've scored knockouts with throws, and it's gonna be cool because I want to give to the guys, like I said, and the ladies. Yes, I want the ladies, so you know I want ladies. So, yeah, I'm here at the Expo collecting business cards from all the supplement sponsors. Clothing sponsors, that's what we just over.
Always doing work, always hustling. Always.
I don't need a manager. I will manage this shit to do it myself.
All right, now, Shoni, man, you can see how MMA has been infused into the Arnold's Festival, man. I know last year it was huge. This year it's even bigger. Just talk about how MMA has kind of taken over and how you see some of these big clothing brands, all the MMA fighters that are sponsored by the nutrition. Just kind of talk about MMA in the Arnold's.
Well, let me tell you, MMA, it seems to not have a ceiling. I mean, whether it's the little kids all the way through the adults, the clothing manufacturers, the supplemental sponsors, it's definitely infused, it's intertwined, mixed. Because I remember when the fighting in a square cage, you didn't have a cage in your dojo, you didn't get into the cage until you were at your fight, to now, the supplemental sponsors will pay to have their logos in the cage and your dojo to being on TV. And it makes the athletes so much better. And I always tell people, if you don't realize the impact of what the supplement companies and the clothing companies have on the industry, imagine if Muhammad Ali, John McEnroe, even golfers, the legends, Arnie Palmer, the tennis players, Maria Shriver. I mean, could you imagine if those athletes had the supplementation that the athletes have like they do today?
Amazing. It really is.
And with the realm of MMA, these athletes, not even 13 years old, have muscles. They have muscles.
It's crazy.
And you have the, like I said, just the infusion of the clothing and the marketing, and it's changed the game.
Now you're a man that's known for your showmanship. Obviously, I mean, you're rocking the hat. I mean, always sticking out, man. Yeah. And the kilt. I mean, you got the full get up, man. A lot of fighters don't do that anymore. You don't see a lot of it. Man, you got your Tom Lawler, he'll come out, some crazy stuff with his entrances. But the most part, you don't see a lot of showmanship. I mean, you think that's a problem? You think we need to bring that back in?
The thing is that I know there are guys that want to be tough. Go ahead, be tough. But realize this. It was once Vale Tudo. Then turned to Ultimate Fighting. Then turned to MMA. MMA turned into mixed modern martial arts entertainment. People live vicariously through the idea of the gladiator. This is why the cage was brought up. So you don't fall out the ring. Nobody... You know, you don't fall out the arena, but you have to give them something now because there are so many of us that the fan wants to be entertained. They want to see more than a punch, a kick, or an arm bar, or a leg lock, or a choke. Yeah. They need to see the celebration, the fanfare, the pomp and circumstance before the fight, during, and then after. This is why we have those notorious after parties. And literally,
you've been involved in a few of those.
You know, I've read a book, seen some footage, and I tell the guys is that a lot of people, you know about my spinning back fist.
Of course.
But you remember the hip shake with the Speedos, and then you see me walk in with the fanfare with the silk on rayon suit. You know, then you hear the deep voice and you see the lovely ladies around me. And I'm like, yeah, guys, even the women.
Ramp it up.
Look what Ronda Rousey's doing. You know what I'm saying? She talking shit about the ring girls to GSP. And
she don't care.
And that's her thing. That's her thing. At least it's a mouthpiece. We look at what the boy, Chael Sonnen. Yeah, he talked more shit than a clogged toilet. You know, I mean, you have to. I laugh because I was doing what Chael was doing. Now, I did this shit years ago, and before me, it was this dude called Muhammad Ali.
Of course.
And I'm like this. You got to have fun with it, because one day you're not going to be famous no more. You can be a great fighter, but if they don't care because you shoot a double leg, lay on them, and win, you'll get cut from the UFC. I ain't said no name.
It just happened.
Hey, I love you though. I mean, you the shit, homie. And I want to say your name, but that's bullshit. Cause you fought and beat me, motherfucker.
Yeah, we know who you're talking. Hey, here's a question for you. We lost Hector Macho Camacho last year. And I know, man, a guy that puts all that emphasis into the outfit, the showmanship.
Yeah.
That had to be somebody that you looked up to, that you looked back and you saw all the things that he did. What a tragedy. How did that affect you?
It literally hurt me with Hector, Bill Superfoot, Wallace. I mean, when we lose those guys, I mean, you know, people die every day and nobody's impervious to death. But when you hear things that are tragic, you know, you wonder who's the guidance, who's the one, that homie that says, dog, come on. Because I've been lucky myself. I've been in some precarious situations. But to a guy who I looked up to, you know, and understood the fight business, the entity, the spirit, the camaraderie of it all, it's like, damn. Damn.
Sad, man.
Sergio Oliva, when he passed. Damn. Because I've met him a few times. And coming out of Chicago, my gym, Chicago Fitness Center, my instructor's a 27-year cop. Sergio Oliva, the myth, he was a Chicago cop. Him and my instructor were friends. I met Sergio Oliva and told him who I am. And he's like, oh, Sean, I know you. I'm like, oh my God, Sergio Oliva knows me. And then, you know, I didn't get a chance to meet, you know, Hector Camacho. But in a sense, I knew him because I know the entity of what it is that he did. He talked shit, backed it up, and looked good doing it.
Yep.
And Ali, same thing. He talked shit, looked good, and backed it up doing it. And that's the thing. I tell people, have fun, market yourself, because how many Scribble Scrabble shirts, how many mohawks, how many pecs and abs are there? A lot. And I'm not talking just about the boys.
Shoney, one final question, man. Who in the UFC right now are you really looking at, fighters coming up, man, that you just like to watch, some of your favorite fighters to watch right now? And it doesn't even have to be the UFC. It could be Bellator. It could be all over the world. Really, you're international, so I know you watch them all. So who are you really liking right now?
I like those little dudes.
Yeah.
It's not
the flyweights, the real little ones. Mighty Mouse.
Yeah. Little motherfucker, sit your ass still sometime. You know, anything that's Jose Aldo and under, goddamn. Can I get a drop of sweat and manufacture that shit? Because that's some go-go juice. You know, I'll give Clay Guida his bounce around hair credit. I love Uriah. I mean, those guys, them little dudes, man, I just be like, I've had to work out with a couple of them, and I turned into an oak tree because I said, I'm not that fast.
Yeah.
So literally, fight. And literally, they would punch and kick, and like, they would like, I'm like, poof, 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 smash, little fucker.
Shoney, go. What more can you say? Shoney Carter, Mr. International, right here at the Arnold Sports Festival in Columbus, Ohio. Cyrus Feast, Fight Now TV.